So these are the different types of amino acids. All these are the chemical substances consist of amine and acid. Some of the amino acids are also having some different functional groups in addition to amine and acid. Here, based on the position of amine with respect to the position of acid, different types of amino acids are available. So these amino acids are represented as COOH or HNH2. So this is the general representation of alpha amino acid, because this is the first carbon and this is the second carbon. With respect to the acid or carbonyl functional group, whatever the carbon present adjacent to carbonyl functional group or any functional group is called as alpha. That means in the represented amino acids, with respect to the position of acid, amine group present at alpha carbon, hence it is called as alpha amino acids. Similarly, I would like to take one more general example, COOH. This is here, this is here, this is here, and this is here, R. What it is, it seems to be Fischer projection formula. So once again, this is the functional group. It is called as functional group, carboxylic acid functional group. So with respect to the carboxylic acid functional group, the importance goes to this carbon, first carbon, and this is second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon, fifth carbon. Whatever the carbon which is directly connected to carbonyl carbon is called as alpha. That means, with respect to acid functional group, if amine group present, NH2 group, that is amino group present at this carbon, then it is called as alpha amino acid. Similarly, whatever the carbon present adjacent to alpha is called as beta. Now, if the same amino group, NH2, present this at this position, then that is called as beta amino acid. Similarly, it is called as gamma. If with respect to acid, if any amino group present at this position, then this is called as gamma amino acid, and this is called as delta. That means with respect to the position of acid and amine, so various types of amino acids are available. They may be alpha amino acids, beta amino acids, gamma amino acids, and delta amino acids, etc. Here, one important statement we have to remember, that naturally or all naturally available amino acids are naturally available amino acids are alpha amino acids only. That means this type of amino acids are only available in the nature, whereas there is no availability, natural availability of beta amino acids, gamma amino acids, and delta amino acids. So prior importance goes to alpha amino acids only, because these are only available in the nature. And the most important thing we have to remember, that these amino acids are widely available in plants, are biosynthesized in plants, whereas so all such type of amino acids are not at all biosynthesized in human beings or animal body. So based on this, we can classify amino acids into different categories. So let us explain different types of classification before completion of what is specificity of R here. So once again, the chemical substances which are made up of amino group and acid group are called as amino acids. Based on position of, with respect to the position of acid, the amine group may be present at alpha position or beta position or gamma position or delta position. If amino group present at alpha position, then they are called as alpha amino acid. If it is present at beta position, beta amino acid, gamma position, gamma amino acid, delta position, delta amino acids. But we have to remember that the most important statement, all naturally available amino acids are alpha amino acids only. So let us have what is R here. What is R here in the general representation of amino acids? By substituting R group with different groups, it is possible to produce 20 different types of alpha amino acids. So these alpha amino acids are called as naturally available alpha amino acids. Let us have some examples. In the given general representation, this is the general structure of amino acid. Now in the general structure, if R is substituted with hydrogen, that means COOH, this is the second carbon, the second carbon connected to NH2 left side and hydrogen right side, in place of R what we have to write? Hydrogen. So in place of R, if I want to write hydrogen, then it is COOH, CH2, NH2, then this is called as glycine. At that time, the name of such amino acid, at which condition? If in the general representation of amino acid, if R is substituted with hydrogen, then the resulting amino acid is called as glycine. Not only glycine, all these naturally available amino acids are produced or given based on their trival character. What is trival character means? The word glycine is produced from Greek language glycose.